Now, divorce can be a bitter and acrimonious process filled with finding fault. The law itself calls for one party to blame the other. That is kind of a requirement at the moment.
However, one group of lawyers is campaigning to introduce the no-fault divorce bill. They say it's going to allow marriages to end in a more amicable manner.
We're joined now by John Oxley, a barrister and campaign manager for the Family Law Reform. And Thomas Pascoe from the Coalition of Marriage joins us from our London newsroom. Morning to both of you. Thanks very much for coming in. Why does it need to be reformed?
The current process dates from the 1970s. The law was written in the 1960s when our approach to divorce was very, very different. Society was very, very different. At the moment, it's not fit for how we feel about divorce. Divorce is something we now accept as part of society. And what the current system does is makes couples separating far more acrimonious than it needs to be. And that has a long-term impact on their relationship and particularly the relationship they might have with their children.
So even if a couple are splitting up, as we say, amicably, divorce process forces one of them to lodge the divorce against the other.
Yes, one person has to petition. They have to say either they have to wait for 2 years of separation to pass, or in most cases they have to say to the court, these are the reasons I want to get divorced, and the court potentially can look at that reasons and say, we don't think they're good enough, we're going to make you stay together in your marriage.
OK, Thomas, you're hearing what John's just been saying. You're part of the campaign of the Coalition for Marriage. This isn't about undermining the institution of marriage. This is about when marriages are irreparable. They're irreconcilable couples and they need to make a split. Surely this is a good idea.
Well, it's actually about something different to that. What it's about is putting the convenience of the wealthy through few above the protections available to the many. What do I mean by that? Well, Mr. Oxley represents chambers which represents high net worth clients, and for them the court process is incredibly inconvenient because you have to go to court, assign blame, and then disclose your financial information to the public. So there's a very good reason why they would like to be able to solve everything amicably off the table and not invoke the courts. However, the courts for vulnerable people are incredibly important and the blame process is part of that. What I'm concerned about is that you'll get situations where you have, for instance, somebody who's bullied within a marriage, somebody who is the victim of potentially domestic violence, whose partner comes to them and says, well, we're going to get a no-fault divorce, and then applies pressure on that person to come up with a divorce and with a settlement that is against their interests. We've been contacted by some of our supporters who are disabled, for instance, in the past, when their disability has come on them midway through life. And they say the protection of the divorce system as it stands at the moment, the fact that one person can't just give notice and step out of the divorce and say, OK, well, in 3 months' time, we're going to have a no-fault divorce and there's nothing you can do about it. It's very, very important to them. It provides them a little bit of security. So because we as a society owe more of a duty to the very vulnerable than we do to the very well-off, I would say that we need to keep the law as it is.
OK, John, so by having no court procedures, you are putting at risk those who are vulnerable, who are perhaps under pressure, who are victims in marriage.
I would say it's very much the opposite. By putting this hurdle for divorce, people who have been, certainly clients we have represented, who've been subject to horrendous abuse, you know, physical abuse, sexual abuse within their marriage, are very, very frightened of taking the step of initiating divorce because they know they have to send a document setting all this out to the other side, and they're really worried about the response of that. And on the vulnerable, the other thing I would say is this process, where virtually all the divorces anyone has asked for in the last 40 years have been granted, but it has to go through a judge. And that means judges are going through these forms rather than spending their days looking at the very urgent care cases, the very urgent public law cases that their expertise is really needed for. So if anything, taking this burden away from the courts and making it more of an administrative process would free up more court time for spending the time that is really needed on those very vulnerable cases involving vulnerable children and adults.
Thomas, isn't it the case that in some relationships there is no one to blame? It just comes to an end, as I say, I use that word, amicably. So why not have no fault? They just agree to separate.
Well, I think that would cover a very, very small minority of cases. And again, you tend to be thinking at the top end of the social strata here. I mean, we're thinking about conscious uncoupling, where both parties decide to step apart. I think there'd be dozens of cases like that over the course of the year. At the moment, we again have to make law on the basis of the many and not the few. So one of the things about the current divorce system, which I think is important, is that because of the cooling off time that's provided between filing the petition and actually going through all of the motions and getting the decree absolute granted by the judge, is about 10% of people drop out. And that's 10,000 marriages saved a year, around 20,000 people affected. And that's very, very important. So we have to balance the convenience, again, to one party on the one hand, and as I say, it's probably dozens, whereas on the other, we have all of those marriages saved by, at the moment, recognising marriage for the important thing that it is, and saying something this vital, this important, needs to go through due process.
OK, it's interesting and it affects a lot of people. Thomas, John, thank you very much indeed. Thanks for your time. Yeah.